I want to read from Acts chapter 2. Acts 2, 26, 27, 28. Acts 2, 26, 27, 28. Maybe a verse before that. I saw the Lord continually before me, because He is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was glad and my tongue was overjoyed. Moreover, my flesh also will live in hope. For you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor will you allow your holy ones to undergo decay. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. And today I want to testify that His presence in your life will bring joy and gladness. It'll bring rejoicing. We have defined some criteria for happiness. We have defined, but God's criteria are different. And the moment we realize that and walk in His will, the rejoicing will come. Okay. And I thought of what to share today, and God told me to share some stories from your life. I want to share a very interesting incident that happened to both me and Medu mostly. And some of you know about it, some of you have prayed about it. And this is for the rest of you who have not really been aware of what was happening. 3 years back, Medu had a health issue. On the outset, it was something very simple, but it is mostly allergic reaction. Allergic reaction, and what it leads to is you'll start choking because it's an allergic reaction. Your throat gets affected. Doctor said you have to be careful, otherwise. This started around the month of September. This is 2018, month of September. And the Lord told me this will go only by prayer. This allergy became almost a daily occurrence. If not daily, once in 2 days. And we had to take Citricin every time it happened to us. She had to take Citricin. And it was almost every day. So we had Citricin at home, Citricin in the car, Citricin in the purse, Citricin in Midu's house, just in case. We started visiting doctors, hospitals. And then one person said, there is this one doctor there. You have to try the doctor. And we went there, we tried the doctor. And we realize that we are at borderline witchcraft. Okay? And this is not a joke. It's not a joke. And Medu came back, and I was not there with the doctor, so Medu came back and said, we are not doing this. And she stopped it immediately. It was too much to even think about it. Now looking back, it's scary. Around that time, the prayers intensified, praying in church, praying at home. So this was September, October, November, December, January, February. If if I do my math correctly, that is around 100 citrulline tablets. And in February 2019, God did something. Anybody remember here what happened in February 2019? February 2019, what happened in this church? It is miracle weekends. The man of God prayed over her. And do you know what the man of God told? The man of God told, "You are healed." And then the man of God said, "You will have one more manifestation." And that's it. That was February 23rd. On February 24th, it manifested again. And that was the last. February 24th till this date, not a single citrulline tablet, completely healed, no recurrence. I remember when we told people, you know what they said? "This is allergic, it's going to come back again." 2018, 19, 20, 21, 22. The Lord said clearly, "This is by prayer." I asked the Lord, "This is what I have to share?" He said, "You preach." This is last year, 2021. You know, those days, our pastor had a heart to come out and pray for us more often. So he was praying there for me and he said something. I'm not going to share what it is. Something very personal he said. I don't think he even remembers. But just to give you an idea of what he said, I'm going to give you an example. Okay, I'm not saying this is nothing to do with what he said, but I'm going to give you an example. You know, when Abraham... What was God's promise to Abraham? He'll make you his descendants like the stars. You see, it is easy to tell somebody with 10 children that I will make your descendants like your stars. Very easy. 10 children. But make that promise to somebody who doesn't have a child. While he was praying, he made a statement like that in my life. Nothing to do with child, but something else. And we sat and prayed. Night after night, me and Madhu prayed about it. In 2021, it came to pass. It is said of Abraham, without becoming weak in faith, he contemplated his body, his situation, now as good as dead, since he was about 100 years. And the deadness of Sarah's womb, yet with respect to the promise of God, he did not waver in unbelief, but grew strong in faith, giving glory to God. And being fully assured that what God has promised, he was able also to perform. Amen. how God promises the impossible. What is possible, man might say, but our God is a God of impossibles. The reason I'm sharing all this at the time of breaking bread is, if His presence is there in our lives, there is no impossibles. The two incidents I have shared from my life, those were real impossibles. The doctors gave up. In some ways, everybody lost hope. Imagine carrying Cetirizine tablets in every bag that you have. It was there in my purse also. But our God, He promises the impossible, and what He gives us will give us rejoicing. His presence in our lives completely gives us rejoicing. I want to make this the anthem for my life. I saw the Lord continually before me because He is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was glad and my tongue was overjoyed. Moreover, my flesh also will live in hope. For You will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor will You allow Your Holy One to undergo decay. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with Your presence.